We came, we saw, we kicked its ass.
Thanks for tuning in. This is Octobotamus coming to another video review. And on today's episode, we are going to be finally assembling the new Ghostbusters Plasma Series Vince Clortho. Now, each of these individual figures came with a piece that lets you build this extra figure. The four Ghostbusters came with the different legs, both the front and back. Dana came with the main torso, and Gozer came with the head. So let's get going. So now these ones here that don't have this upper elbow joint, these are going to be the back legs. It also doesn't have a hinge up here. It just rotates. So you plug that in right like that. Do that with this one here. Get that in there. Come on, there we are. All right. Get that in there nice and tight. Then these come up here. And these create the upper legs, and you can see just how really kind of big this guy gets. That's quite impressive so far. And now finally we're gonna put the head, and that's just the ball joint. Get in there. There we go. And there you have them. The Terror Dog, pretty big by comparison, as you can see, to the rest of the figures that are in this line.
Knocking down poor Winston. What's happening? There you go, Winston. I'm sorry, buddy. You hang out right there. But
the overall size is pretty impressive by comparison. And obviously, a worthy build-a-figure sort of just piece, I guess. Get Dana to stand properly. And she don't want to. Come on, Dana. Come on, Dana Burger. There we go. Dana Burger.
You guys, if you guys know the reference Dana Burger, I'm impressed with your 90s trivia. Why don't you want to stand here? You were just standing a second ago. What's happening?
All right, there we go. But really very nice. Detail is really good. The sculpted detail throughout the entire figure is pretty much on point. It's got a whole bunch of different wrinkles, some folds, some ugly bumps in everything. The claws are nicely painted with the front section here, and then the back bits. I like how that looks. I talked about this before, but you got this nice silver metallic paint going down the back side of Vince, which does look really cool. Come around to the face. Great detail in there. Ugly as sin. I mean, that is quite hideous looking. Got some really nice red eyes. The horns are all painted. Great detail with the mouth. For his articulation, you can see that the head is on two different ball joints. So you got a lower joint. The problem though is when you do rotate it, you get this ugly hole that's there. That's always going to be there, but you can articulate that left and right, which is nice. It can look up and down. He can do a rotation. The mouth actually opens, which is fantastic. You get a really gruesome look inside there with the tongue. The teeth are really dirty and everything. You can kind of even see like the throat there, which that's really cool. The front legs here can articulate out on a hinge, and then they have a swivel. The elbow here does have that pin hinge joint, so you can rotate that forward and back, hinge it up and down, and then you have that same type of joint. Well, or is it that just one? Oh, that's one of those weird ass twisty joints. So it goes forward and back, and then it rotates. So you can do that. The back legs here, a little unfortunate that it's not as articulated. They just swivel forward and back, but I guess you don't really need too much there. Although, I mean, I kind of would like it if you could at least get them to sit. Well, no, you kind of could, I guess. Let's see. You bring that around. I mean, yeah, you can kind of get him sitting, I guess. Sit, boo-boo, sit. Good dog. So you do have that. I do wish that they had a joint right there, though. That would have been nice. The tail is a softer material, so you can wag them, I guess. I think that things like this have to be a soft material just so that they don't cut anybody or stab anyone, I should say. But overall, solid. Really very solid. And like I said, I don't think that this would have been a figure people would have bought just by himself. I mean, it's definitely possible. We have gotten Terror Dogs in the past, and I want to say people have bought them. Honestly, I don't remember. But the overall presentation
this whole Plasma series has really impressed me. I've been very happy with it. Some people, in reading the comments for the videos, sometimes they don't like standing. My table here is not all that smooth, so it causes problems. But reading some of the comments, some people talked about the Maddie collector figures and how they still think that the Maddie ones are better. Personally, I don't think so. If you do, great. I'm glad. I'm hoping that you enjoy those Maddie collector ones. I just think that this looks better, in my opinion. The overall look of the characters looks better. I think that the overall presentation of them is much better than the Maddie collector ones. Some of the accessories I wish were done a little bit differently, but I really do like this. I hope that the line continues. Obviously, we only have one Terror Dog. We need two of them. I don't know why they really couldn't. Like I said, I don't know necessarily if Vin's Clortho and Zool looked different as a Terror Dog. There might have been very minor differences, which if that's the case, that would be cool to get those differences. But even if we just got a reuse of this, I wouldn't mind terribly. As long as obviously we get new figures to go along with it. That could be fun. I do really hope that we get at least repaints of these guys looking how they did in Ghostbusters 2. I would like to get maybe a new Viggo figure. They can give us a whole bunch of those new ghosts, or at least give us those ghosts that we got in the previous movies, give them to us in their new style. I did read that the majority of the Ghostbuster figures have gotten pushed back to coincide with the release of the movie, which is great. These ones are great to add, but I feel like those other ones are going to be more keyed in to that movie. Maybe like older versions of Peter, Ray, Winston. Unfortunately, we know that Harold Ramis is no longer with us, so he's not going to be in it, but Dana is going to be in it. Janine's going to be in it. A lot of the cast is returning. The only one that I think isn't, obviously, is Harold Ramis. And unfortunately, Rick Moranis isn't as well. That would have been a great kind of surprise. And, you know, he still might. Who knows? But one of the fears that I had with releasing the Ghostbuster figures now, when the movie was supposed to be coming out in July, is that the toy sales would suffer. But it's nice to hear that they are pushing back the main toys to stick with the release of the film. That's nice. But this is a great, great Build-A-Figure. I think the entire first wave has been fantastic. And I really cannot wait to see what they do with the rest. So, all that being said, these new Plasma series will be hitting various retail locations fairly soon. So, if you are looking for them, good luck and happy hunting. Or as always, you can do that really easy thing and just go to Big Bad Toy Store. For that, I'll put a link right down in the video description where you can go to BBTS and check out availability on these guys, as well as the rest of the wide range of Ghostbuster figures. But beyond that, guys, that's about it. Remember, if you like this video, I would really appreciate it if you would do one very small thing for me. And that's simply just to hit that thumbs up button. That one very small gesture really does go a long way towards helping me out, and I would really appreciate it. Also, if you stayed with me through this entire review series, give yourself a thumbs up. I know they're not Transformer figures, and a lot of people tuned into my channel for that. But these are figures that I've absolutely been excited about, and I wanted to share them with you guys. So if you're one of those hardcore fans that stood with me through this entire thing, let me know, and I'll give you a thumbs up. Before I go, I also want to send a huge shout out to all of my patrons, who through their continued support, now more than ever, help to make reviews like this possible. And if you'd like information on how you can help support my channel by becoming a patron, feel free to check out my Patreon page at patreon.com/optobotomus. And as always, remember that the real trouble with the world is that too many people grow up. Thank you for watching and taking the time to be a kid.